Welcome to the NRF 2023 Retail's Big Show. You know, it's great to be back in New York City, but this time at full strength. In this great renovated center, we've got a lot of, we are really gonna enjoy this week. So, you know, thinking about retail, it's mid-January, and that means a few things. Now, one is we survived another holiday season, which is always great. Second, we've had the chance to rest a bit, recuperate, and third, it's only 10 months until the next holiday season. So there's never a dull moment in retail, and that's certainly the case this year. And on behalf of the entire leadership team and the entire NRF staff, it's just so great to see you, and I want to say thank you for attending the 113th annual Big Show. And for anyone that's in this industry in retail, this is the only place that you should be to discover all the best new ideas, the best new technologies, and form new relationships with the industry's best and brightest minds. And the team, we've assembled just a great program that you'll see over these 3 days. And just a bit on the numbers, there'll be more than 35,000 attendees here from 75 countries. So quite a diverse audience. And as far as exhibitors, we have more than 1,000 exhibitors, 175 sessions with 350 speakers. Now I'm also excited that we expanded the Innovation Lab and the Startup Zone. We've added 3 new pavilions to the expo, and we launched a consumer product showcase that features breakthrough products. And what's exciting about this is 84% of those products are presented from diverse or minority-owned companies. And the team has just worked incredibly hard to bring all of this to life, and I want to thank them for their efforts and their dedication to retail. Now, this past year was a historically challenging time. We did see some relief from the pandemic, but we also saw extreme challenges with global supply chains. And that collided with surging demand, a shift in sectors from goods to services, inflation levels that we haven't seen for decades, and the start of a war. But we should be really proud of the retailers all around the world who rose up to meet those challenges head on. But we did what we do best. You know, first, we serve customers. We got them what they wanted and what they needed amidst all of those macro challenges. And second, we innovated. We moved fast to meet the customers' changing needs. And a couple years ago, one of our board members, it's probably here somewhere, Mark Metrick, the CEO of Saks, said something to us in a board meeting that really stuck with me. And what he said was, loyalty in retail is the absence of something better. So loyalty in retail is the absence of something better. And that really rang true. And Mark, I don't know if you came up with that or you heard it from someone else, but that's how retail works. If you're not offering the best customer experience, your customers, they'll just move on to someone else who is. And with the pace of change that we're seeing now across the industry, it's more important than ever that we keep changing. And I'm also proud of the way our industry stepped up to help the communities we serve in those communities' times of need. So you can see here associates from Bath & Body Works who were taking supplies from Miami to Fort Myers on the backside of Hurricane Ian. Bob Eddy, people here from BJ's Wholesale Club that were partnering with Homeland Security during the blizzard in Buffalo last month. And then near and dear to my heart, some of our Walmart associates who were preparing meals for the community in Hazard, Kentucky during last year's flooding. You know, those are all moments that we should be proud of and that make the industry proud. But through it all, the macro environment, the pandemic, natural disasters, historic inflation, retail continued sales growth. We've had positive growth now for 30 consecutive months. And back in March of this last year, the NRF forecasted that retail sales would grow between 6% and 8% for 2022. and we expect that we'll wind up right in the middle of that range for the year. And that's on top of nearly 14% growth back in 2021. And given that this sector, the retail sector, is one of the nation's largest employers, that growth really matters. It matters for our employees, our associates, and it matters for opportunity. You know, there are so many of us here in the room who started working in a local store, a distribution center, or a fulfillment centers more and more. And that's my story. I started working in a Walmart Supercenter as a teenager, and that has led me to my current roles both at Walmart and the NRF. And so many of us are examples of what's possible in this industry. The opportunities, they're real. The opportunities, they matter. And if I could just say now a few things about the NRF itself and its importance. You know, the NRF serves as the industry's eyes, its ears, and its voice in Washington, D.C. And this year, the NRF secured a lot of policy wins with positions on things like, you know, working to help avert a potential rail strike, protecting the corporate tax rate, and addressing privacy issues. You know, we helped with the passage of both the Ocean Shipping Reform Act and the Postal Reform Act. And within the Inflation Reduction Act, it includes exciting opportunities for those of us in the room who are trying to electrify our fleet and shift to more renewable sources of energy. And the NRF is already fast at work with the new Congress advocating for the industry with priorities like reducing inflation, combating organized retail crime, and increasing credit card competition. Additionally, the NRF works really hard at telling our very best stories. You know, stories about the lives we change through great jobs, the impact we have on national and global economies, and the work we all do to ensure a better future for our children by addressing environmental sustainability, diversity, and educational opportunity. And I don't want to miss this opportunity to just say thanks to the entire staff at the NRF. And Matt, to you, thank you for the job you do as the Chief Executive Officer of the NRF. You do a great job representing all of us. So at the NRF, we are honored to work on behalf of all of you and the millions of people who are in retail all over the world. You know, from the programmers to sales associates, from marketers to the technologists, and then the growing ranks of all those in fulfillment centers and transportation teams. Retail is driven by people. And all in all, this environment will remain dynamic, it will remain full of changes, full of challenges, and it's a unique time for all of us and our companies across the industry and retail to serve customers as the wants and needs continue to change. You know, and I just want to leave you with one really important point. This industry is strong. And if we all continue to be open to change, we can achieve so much more.